Yeah, when I went into the Melbourne market, they all told me that I'd go broke. They said, what sort of idiot thinks that someone's going to buy coffee from a Queenslander? And what we did was we had a look at the market again and had a look at the whole concept of be first or be different. I wasn't going to be the first coffee company in Melbourne. I was going to be different. The way I was going to be different is I tackled the cafe owners. I didn't tackle management businesses, and I went after the imported products. So it was a very clear strategy where today 90% of our client base are owner-operators. And why? Because I'm an owner-operator myself. So owners tend to relate to owners. So we like to target the owner-operation businesses because we can relate. When you need something, you need it now. And so what we did was build the whole service component around the owner-operator. It's a strategy that works to this day, and it, you know, and it's led us to be the largest specialty coffee company in this country. According to ASCA, you know, which is the Australasian Specialty Coffee Association, we are the largest member of that group. And where we don't serve coffee to supermarkets, we don't sell coffee to 7-Elevens. That specialty actually means that you use scores of 80 points or above from origin, and it also means that you're found in cafes and restaurants only. So, you know, and we have to put that quantifier on because there's lots of people in the industry that say, well, how do you qualify being the largest specialty roaster? And that's how we quantify it. But, you know, in terms of Melbourne, coffee capital of the world, it still is the coffee capital. So we had to get people in Melbourne to believe and see our vision. And the way we had to do that was to turn the whole industry around. Rather than people come and deliver coffee out of a van, we build a whole service attachment. Who is our target audience? Owner-operators, because they're the ones that really value the service.